Codependent and Narcissistic Relationships. How to Cure Your Soul and Heal from an Abusive and Toxic Relationship. Written by Scott J. Stacey. Narrated by DMS. Codependent. Cure your soul and heal from being in an abusive relationship. Written by Scott J. Stacey. Narrated by DMS. Introduction. Codependent people have grown up in homes in which their parents relied too heavily on each other for emotional support. They watched in disgust as their parents cheated on each other and mistreated each other in different ways. They stayed together long past the point when they should have called it quits. From this experience, the child learned that they were incapable of making it as a healthy and independent child. The codependent unconsciously think that they can't make it without a mate, they are worthless without a mate, and that they are not good enough, along with a host of other negative thoughts. Consciously, they may vow not to become their parents. The codependent and their love relationships. These people are drawn to relationships that start hot and heavy. Because of their strong need to bond with another individual, they often get seriously involved early on in the relationship. Their mate, who is usually also codependent, is always available, loving, and affectionate in the beginning. This is a dream come true for the codependent who constantly craves attention. This is until they begin to feel suffocated by their mate's possessive and jealous personality. They take up all their free time and isolate them from their friends and family. Their mate may demand too much, not only emotionally, but also financially and mentally as well. The codependent thinks they are in love, although they soon become miserable, lonely, and depressed. To other people, this couple may be in love because of the amount of time they spend together and the length of time the relationship can continue. If they should split apart, they soon get back together. Healthy men can be attracted to the dependent personality. However, they are just as quickly turned off by their clingy personality and disappear, or they may stick around and take advantage of their generous ways. Codependents and their interaction with family and friends, but they have a tendency to be very self-absorbed. They ignore other people's wants and needs in order to get what they want and need. They are short-term thinkers who constantly seek instant gratification. The codependent doesn't mean to hurt anyone, but they are often too involved with holding on to their waning relationship to give their family and friends the love and attention they deserve. Their family will always be here, they may be thinking, but they may secretly know their relationship will not be. It is also a possibility that they are too ashamed of who they have become within their relationship to show their faces. If the codependent is not involved in a love relationship, they may behave in a similar fashion with their family and friends. They may keep too close of an eye on their children and prevent them from hanging out with their friends. They may seem to be mean, but they are desperate not to be alone. When hanging out with their friends, the codependent may get upset when their friends invite someone else along. They can also be too loyal to their friends. When the codependent tries to become more independent. Once the codependent tries to stand on their own two feet, their mate may be afraid that they will get left behind. Desperate to hold on, they may become violent, verbally abusive, and manipulative. Sometimes codependents halt their growth because they are afraid they will outgrow their mate or because they are afraid to start over. Codependence at work. It can be hard for the codependent to function at work due to their constantly changing emotions. And because of the tumultuous nature of their relationship, they often have to quit coming to work or call out due to family emergencies. Without an attachment, they are very capable of doing a good job at work and making wise decisions. However, they have the tendency to allow themselves to be mistreated by their coworkers and supervisors, and they may neglect to ask for raises or promotions because of their self-esteem issues. How to get out of a codependent relationship? If the codependent lover is abusive, it is important that they leave right away. A good time to leave is when their mate is not at home. Otherwise, the codependent must begin to make decisions concerning the future and prepare to leave the relationship, unless their mate agrees to improve on their own or to get counseling. However, the codependent must stand their ground and demand to be treated well and receive some reciprocity. What is codependency, and are you guilty of it? Codependency is a learned behavior that can be passed down from one generation to another. It is an emotional and behavioral condition that affects an individual's ability to have a healthy, mutually satisfying relationship. It is also known as relationship addiction because people with codependency often form or maintain relationships that are one-sided, emotionally destructive, and/or abusive. How do you know if you are a codependent? There are many warning signs that may be exhibiting codependency behavior. Listed below are some of the key ones you are likely to display. An exaggerated sense of responsibility for the actions of others. An unhealthy dependence on relationships and a fear of abandonment. An extreme need for approval and recognition. A tendency to confuse love with pity, wanting to rescue the other from their problems. A tendency to do more than your share in a relationship. A sense of guilt when asserting yourself. A lack of trust in yourself and others. Social abilities are the abilities that we use to communicate and interact with each other, both verbally and nonverbally through gestures, body language, and our special appearance. Human beings are sociable animals, and we have created many methods to share our messages, ideas, and emotions with others. What is said is affected by both verbal language and how we use it, voice tone, speech volume, and the words we choose, as well as more subtle messages such as body language, gestures, and other nonverbal techniques of communication. Social skills are the abilities we use to interact with and communicate with others daily. They include verbal and nonverbal communication, such as speech, gesture, expression of the face, and language of the body. An individual has powerful social skills when they know how to act in social circumstances and when interacting with others. They comprehend both written and implied laws. Children with an autism spectrum disorder, ASD, diagnosis, pervasive developmental disorder, not otherwise specified, and Asperger's have social skills problems. Advantages of developing good social skills. Social skills are essential to enable a person to have beneficial relationships with others and to retain them. Many of these abilities are critical to friendship, building and maintaining. Social interactions do not always operate smoothly, and suitable strategies need to be implemented by a person, such as conflict resolution, when interaction problems occur. Having empathy, i.e., being able to put yourself in someone else's shoes and recognize their emotions, is also essential for people as it enables them to react to how others feel in an understanding and caring manner. 1. More and better relationships. Well, identifying with people leads to more relationships and friendships at times. You become more charismatic and desirable feature by improving your social skills. People are more interested in charismatic people because they are more interested in them by charismatic people, or at least seem to be. Most people know that without strong interpersonal relationships, you can't go far in life. Focusing on relationships will assist you in getting a job, getting promoted, and making new friends. Well-honed social skills can boost your happiness and satisfaction and offer you a better life perspective. More relationships can also assist in decreasing stress, adverse impacts, and increase your self-esteem. Number 2, better communication. Naturally, relationships with individuals and being.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.